Hello everyone, I am Ashwini Deshpande from Pimpri Chinchwad College of Engineering. I am working as assistant professor in first year electrical department. Today I am going to present my video for International FDP on Environment and Sustainability conducted by D.Y. Patil College of Engineering, Akurdi, Pune. I am going to cover the environmental standards and renewable energy resources, especially solar electric vehicle. Now the next PPT is just overlook of week 1 video and week 2 video. In week 1, I have covered the introduction of solar electric vehicle technology, and in week 2, I have covered the solar environmental standards and renewable energy resources. Now the outcome for this video are: one should able to understand requirement and need of renewable energy resources, how solar energy is useful for environmental sustainability, what are the ISO standards for renewable energy sources as well as for the solar sources, how electric vehicles are better solution to reduce the carbon footprint. So these are the some outcomes that I am going to cover in this video. Some standards for the solar energy. For solar energy industry, a number of international standards have been defined. These are the standards relating to PV panels, photovoltaic cell plants, operation and maintenance. But some are also applicable to the design, procurement and construction phases of your PV plant. If we design your solar project to meet a particular standard, we have to aware about the level of instrument required to monitor solar irradiance and environmental condition is influenced by the standard mentioned in below table. These are the standards related with the PV panels, as well as in addition to this, ISO TC22 covers all the things related with the design of solar electric vehicle. So solar electric vehicle as well as the electric vehicle, these are also beneficial for environmental sustainability. Some standards are here. First one, IEC 61724-1, PV system performance monitoring. This standard relates to performance monitoring and analysis of solar energy plants from irradiance input to AC power output. It defines terminologies and classifies instruments and methods. ISO 9060, pyranometers and parallelismeter. ISO 9060 is titled Solar Energy Specification and Classification of Instruments for Measuring Hemispherical Solar and Direct Solar Radiations. In November 2018, an updated standard replaced the 1990 standard. The main difference is just the change of classification. ISO calibration standards. A number of international standards related to the solar energy requires that pyranometers are calibrated in accordance with ISO 9846-1993 or ISO 9847-1992. IEC 61724-1 is one of these standards. So these are the standards just giving you the idea about the solar systems or the related with the solar electric panels. Now calculations of carbon footprint. There is a comparison for carbon footprints coming out with the three types of vehicles. The vehicle that is the conventional cars runs on the gasoline and tend to be direct or more expensive fuel than EVs. That is shown here. You can see the 381 grams of CO2 per mile is the carbon footprint or the emission of the CO2 from that gasoline only. That is the conventional car, which is emitting the 381 grams of CO2 per mile. Next is the plug-in hybrid electric vehicle. Plug-in hybrid electric vehicle means it is partially working on the solar or conventional and partially work on the electrical. Partially work on the gasoline and partially work on the electricity. So plug-in hybrid use both gasoline and electricity and can be recharged from the outlet. you can see 191 grams of CO2 per mile is the emission of carbon from that plug-in hybrid electric vehicle. Now the battery electric vehicles run on the electricity and are some of the cleanest and cheapest car to drive, and the emission of carbon is 123 grams of CO2 per mile. So comparatively, the battery electric vehicle emits the less carbon. And in addition to the battery electric vehicle, if it is the solar electric vehicle, then it is more beneficial because that electricity generated with the help of solar is more sustainable and more clean energy comparative to the conventional source of electric energy. So battery electric vehicle is the advantage, but addition to this, solar battery electric vehicle is most advantageous. In next slide, we can see the basic calculations or the comparison in between petrol car, other electric vehicle, as well as the solar car. If you compare the fuel point of view, petrol, electricity and solar electricity, these are the three things as required for the vehicles as a fuel. Now the fuel unit rate. We know that the petrol cost is 72 rupees per liter. Other electric vehicle we can take as average, that is 22.5 per charge unit. And if you take the solar car, solar electric vehicle, it will be just 5 rupees per charge unit. Mileage 12 kilometers per liter, 75 kilometers per charge, and you can see here the 101 kilometer per charge. Running cost, that is the 6 rupees. Here it is 0.3, and here in the solar car it is 0.05 only. Average spending of fuel per year, here you can see the huge amount, which is 64,800. In other electric vehicles, suppose it is battery electrical vehicle, or the electricity used, which is conventional electricity, is 3240. But if you take the cost for the solar electric vehicle, it is just 540 rupees. So you can see this difference. It is a very huge difference. Solar electric vehicle is always beneficial as per the cost point of view, as well as the carbon footprint or the carbon emission point of view. Solar electric vehicle is the green solution for upcoming days. We can see this, the sustainable development is equal to the consumptions of renewable energy resources, in which covers the air quality, water, soil, ecoforestry, marine lives, biospecies. So sustainable development is the need of today's world because of the global warming and various problems related with the conventional systems with fossil fuels. In short, the summary of the video or the summary of my topic is, nowadays dealers of natural resources like fuel, coal, etc. are facing a hard time to keep pace with increasing demand. We know that demand for the fuel goes on increasing day by day. At one hand, there are more cars or motors, vehicles are dominating the transport medium. On the other hand, these cars are being dominated by the fuel. As a result, the limited resources are being quashed by the procedures and dealers to satisfy this need, which is leading us to an uncertain future with having the scarcity of the fuel and mineral. Scarcity of the fuel and mineral is the most important or the high priority challenge in front of us, as well as it is clear that present ends in energy consumption, especially oil, cannot be sustained much longer. Also, these are responsible for the global warming, environmental imbalance, ozone layer depletion, etc. We are facing a lot of problems, environmental issue with the consumptions of the fossil fuels. One more point is the limited availability, and second point is the global warming and increase in temperature and impact on the environment. Now, which in turn is a big threat to the future human race. Again, in view of the possibility of global warming, these resources are playing a negative role. Therefore, under these circumstances, it is quite necessary to make a new exploration of natural resource of energy and power. But why exploration when resource is in front of our bare eye? It is effective, less expensive, and above all, it is an endless source of energy. With greatly improved energy efficiency, a transition to this energy-based economy capable of sustaining the anticipated growth in the world economy is possible. And this effective source is the solar energy. So solar energy is beneficial in all the aspects. Plus, it is the endless source of energy, and it will help us to reduce the temperature and environmental impacts which are causing because of the traditional or the conventional energy or the fuels that we are using. So my focus is on the electric vehicle as well as solar electric vehicle. So solar energy is one of the renewable source of energy which will help us for giving the sustainable development in electrical energy point of view. Thank you.